What's up, filmmakers and creators? Today I'm going to show you how you make a separated glitch effect inside of Premiere Pro. If you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing. I got a lot of filmmaking and video editing tutorials coming up, so smash that bell. Applying a glitch effect is really simple, but what if you want to separate a subject or an object in that glitch? So today I'm going to show you how to make a separated glitch effect. Let's jump into the computer and I'll show you how. On the timeline right here, I have some footage of myself. Now you can glitch out a person or you can glitch out the background. But in this case, I'm going to focus on making myself glitch out in the frame. So what we need to do is we need to go over to Effect Controls panel. And if you can't see that, you can go to Window and select the effects, or you can type Shift plus F7 on your keyboard. In the effects controls panel, under opacity, I'm going to select free draw Bezier. And now when you select that, it will create a mask. So I'm going to free draw a mask around myself, and just starting with a point right here. And I'm just going to select the second point right there. And you can play around with this, but try to make it as close to your subject as possible, so you can have clean lines going through all of this footage. One thing that you can do to make this process a little bit easier is to go here and select a zoom level. So if we zoom into 100% and just adjust the frame a little bit, we can have more precise control over our masking. So I'm just going to continue masking around my head right here. Now I'm going to speed up the video a little bit and draw around myself, and I will be back after that. After you have masked out your subject, you can now go back on the player head right here and see how it performs. In this case, it moves a little bit. So I'm going to show you how you can animate this keyframe to follow your subject. So I'm going to start from the beginning of the clip, and I'm going to select the mask, and I'm just going to drag it down a little bit. Then I'm going to start animating. So to animate the mask path, you click this stopwatch right here, click toggle animation, and we can go maybe a couple of frames forward and select the mask again and just drag it so it fits your subject. And when you are creating an animation like this, you will have keyframes here on the timeline and you can see how the footage is animated. So if we go and finish this one up, just going to drag the mask a little bit up there. And like I said, it doesn't have to be perfect for this special effect. And in this example, I'm going to use the glitch pack 1 that I have in my filmmaking store. And you can find a link to that preset down in the description below. So I'm going to go to my presets, Vegard Heyerdahl presets, glitch pack 1, and in this example I'm just going to use cinematic corrupt, and I'm going to just drag it onto my footage just like that. And now you will see we have a transition where I'm glitching out. To make this footage look even cooler, we can have a background. As you probably have noticed, the background of my video is completely black. And that is because we have no footage behind this glitch. So what I'm going to do is to drag my footage on top of this other clip right here. And you will see right here that we have the glitched out me on top of this footage. Now you can go into the effect controls and you can scale this up and down how you like. So for example, if you want to have a smaller version of this glitch, you can simply just drag it just right there and you will appear right there.
If you don't want to miss out on future filmmaking and video editing tutorials, make sure to subscribe and smash that bell. so you don't miss any future videos. Create and inspire, and I will see you in the next video.